श्री साईराम रेस्पेक्टेड एल्डर्स सिस्टर्स एंड ब्रदर्स ऑफ साई फैमिली ए लविंग साईराम टू यू ऑल वेलकम टू समर्पण एंड ऑफरिंग ऑफ ग्रैटिट्यूड फ्रॉम द अलुमनी श्री सत्यसाई एजुकेशनल इंस्टीट्यूशंस हेल्ड ऑन द थर्ड संडे ऑफ एवरी मंथ इट इज एन इवनिंग फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस टू गेट टुगेदर एंड रिलीव आवर मोस्ट चेरिश्ड मेमोरीज विद अ ब्यूटिफुल लॉर्ड स्पेंट ओवर द decade or more recapitulate his word his work and his way and share this joy and bliss with everybody else this samarpan we are blessed to have with us Sri Venkateshwarulu garu the deputy warden of the Sri Satyasai junior boys hostel in Puttaparthi as a guest speaker sir hails from Bilaspur right from 1974 sir has been a balika student and in the Year 1979, sir had his first darshan of Bhagwan at this very place when he came for attending the summer course in Vrindavan. Sir completed his BSc, his MSc Maths and his B.Ed in Ravi Shankar University, Raipur. And in the year 1986, under Swami's divine command, sir joined the school at Puttaparthi as a lecturer in mathematics. And in the year 1989, under the divine command again, sir joined the school hostel. And in the year 1995, when the school hostel was established, Swami appointed him and blessed him as a deputy warden of the hostel. And currently he serves there as a mathematics lecturer for the higher secondary school. Among the student community, sir's passion for students' welfare and his eagerness to encourage students in whatever they do makes him something unique and that's what makes him stand out. Besides all this distinction, what makes him all the more special is the direct guidance which he has obtained from Bhagwan himself from time to time. And sir could always understand what Swami's likes and dislikes are. And today he is with us to share from his treasure trove experiences those beloved moments which he cherished for the whole lifetime which he had with Bhagwan. And let us all immerse ourselves in Dr. Venkateshwarulu garu's reminiscences of the Lord's Mahima and Leelas. Over to you, sir.
Om Shri Sairam. Offering my most humble and reverential pranams at Bhagwan's lotus feet, respected elders, brothers and sisters, Sairam to one and all. I consider this a great honor conferred upon me by inviting me to share the wonderful times we had with Bhagwan and take this opportunity as expressing my gratefulness to Bhagwan for all that which he's been doing right from the time he entered my life, all these years and the years to come. To begin with, the moment I step inside Vrindavan, so many memories flood in. Even though I was attending Balvikas right from 1974. For the first time I had Darshan of Bhagwan in the year 1979. It was January 10th, just before the Sankranti festival. And the moment I saw Bhagwan, I was so excited seeing the students surrounding him and he in turn giving them wonderful opportunities. In the first darshan itself, I had a desire that how nice if I can be a student. In fact, after 3 days of stay, when I was moving back to my hometown, I went with this prayer, Swami, I wish to be a student. And Swami had a mysterious ways of fulfilling our wishes. It so happened that Darshan of Bhagwan was so inspiring that I started became a very active member in the organization, taking part in every activity, whether it was Balvikas, whether it is Narayan Seva, whether it was medical camps, eye camps. In every activity I started taking part. And just after 2 months of Bhagwan's Darshan, there was an announcement in the Samiti at the end of the Bhajan session by the district president of Bilaspur, saying that Bhagwan is organizing a summer course, which he was been doing for last few years, and the criteria to join that summer course is that you should be a college student, means you should be pursuing your collegiate education. As I was doing at that point of time, I was in first year BSc. And then it was told that we should write an entrance examination. So some of us who are doing college study, some who are doing engineering, some who are doing medicine, many of us, we wrote the test. Fortunately, I got the chance from my place to attend the summer course. I was so excited when I received the letter informing me that I have been selected and I can attend the summer course. During those years, the summer course used to be in the month of May, starting on 1st of May, and used to go on till 30th of May, one full month in Divya Sannidhi, in the proximity of Bhagwan. There used to be around 1,000 students attending the summer course from all parts of the country, and good number of boys from Bhagwan's college itself. But a problem arose. The problem was that our university examinations were to commence from 21st of April till 10th of May. It means that I have to miss some of the examinations. So my parents did not agree. They said that you can try next year. You can go and attend the summer course next year. This time you cannot attend. You cannot miss your academic year. I was very disappointed. Kept praying to Swami to show me the way how I can attend the summer course. After 3 days, suddenly a beautiful idea struck to me. I have 3 brothers. One of my brother was suffering from kidney ailment almost for a decade. He was very brilliant academically, so he did not lose any academic year, but almost 2 to 3 months in a year, he used to be admitted in the hospital. We took him to various doctors in the city. We took him to Bombay. We took him to Delhi. But his ailment continued. So I approached my mother, saying that if you allow me to attend summer course, I may get an opportunity to pray to Bhagwan and Swami may bless him with good health. She thought for a while and then agreed, taking a promise from me that I should not be losing the academic year. I promised her that I'll come back and take the supplementary examination, and in the process, I will not lose the academic year. I need not repeat the first year BSc. So I came to attend summer course. And this was the premises where the grand summer course was organized. We were living in this hostel. It was such a wonderful time. Swami interacting almost every day, coming for food sessions. I remember those wonderful times. Swami personally used to distribute ice creams to 1,000 students. We used to have very hectic schedule. Early in the morning, we used to come for Nagar Sankirtan, go around Swami's Mandir. Swami used to give Vishwarup Darshan. And then the matadors were arranged for boys to go and do social service. Sometimes Swami used to come to that particular village or the spot where we were serving and give us darshan, and it was a wonderful sight seeing Swami in those places. You come back from that summer, that social service, we used to have classes. We'll come back for lunch. After lunch again, we used to have classes. Come back for tea and go back. And the best part of the day, that is, we used to have beautiful bhajans followed by Bhagwan's nectarine discourses. After that, on Thursdays and Sundays, we also used to have music programs and several other things. It was a wonderful time, one full month in Bhagwan's company. I was trying my best to somehow inform Swami about brother's ailment, but the number of students was so huge that I could not get any opportunity. Then it was told that Swami is going to bless the students who have come from various states with an interview. So one day it was the turn of students from Madhya Pradesh to have this wonderful time with Swami. So I thought this will be the time I will inform Bhagwan. Swami called us for interview. As soon as we went inside, he sat on his simhasan. The first thing he said, no personal questions. I was a bit disappointed, but in the same time, the proximity of Bhagwan was so great that I just completely forgot about it, enjoying the bliss which we could never imagine to experience in our lifetime. We had a very long session, almost an hour time. Everyone was asking whatever questions they have to ask, and very patiently, very lovingly, Swami was answering them. And the session ended. Swami distributed Vibhuti Prasadam, gave Padnamaskar, and we came out. That memory remained for a very long period of time, the time spent with Bhagwan. Every now and then we used to recollect those wonderful moments which we spent with Swami. Month passed, summer course was over, exam was conducted, Swami gave certificates, and several other things took place. The day we have to leave, I was wondering what I am going to tell my mother. Suddenly there was an announcement saying that those students who are not visited Puttaparthi can accompany Bhagwan. Swami has arranged buses, so we can go along with Swami to Puttaparthi. As I had not seen Puttaparthi, I gave my name, and on the next day we left for Puttaparthi. On the way we had a wonderful time in Muddanahalli as they organized a grand lunch, and Swami spoke in Kannada. For the first time I heard Swami speaking in other language than Telugu. We went to Parthi. It was the year 1979. By then the college, our school, our primary school, all these things have not come up. The construction work started. Only the Ishwaramba school was existing. So we have been accommodated in the old hostel where the Brindavan boys stay now whenever they visit Parthi. And we had a privilege of sitting in the portico, that these are the summer course boys. We were not very large in number, but in the same time the privilege was conferred upon us. So on the next day, when Swami came out to give darshan, I kneeled down and try bringing Swami's attention. I said, Swami, brother, even before I could complete sentence, he said, I know, before you go, I will give prasadam. I was very happy. I thought the purpose of my visit is going to find fulfillment. I can go boldly and tell my mother that Swami has given prasadam. Finally, the day came when I had to leave. The train was in Dharmavaram at 12 o'clock in the afternoon. That morning, once again, I reminded Swami that, Swami, I am going today. Swami said, I will give prasadam bhajan time. I was eagerly waiting. As I mentioned, there was nobody else in the portico. So we used to move front outside the bhajan hall to have Swami's darshan during bhajan time. Bhajans were on, and I was wondering, did Swami forget? And what will happen? Because after bhajans, he used to take aarti and go inside, and next darshan will be in the afternoon only. So I started praying very intensely. Suddenly Swami looked at me. He got up from his simhasan, went inside the interview room, came out with the vibhuti bag, the bag containing vibhuti packets, called me, gave me one handful of vibhuti packets. I received them and I took namaskar. Before taking namaskar, I put the vibhuti packets in my right pocket and I took namaskar. As I got up, Swami was holding another handful of packets. He said, "That is for you." And he gave once again a handful of vibhuti packets, saying, "This is for your brother." I was very happy. Since it was same vibhuti prasadam, I was about to put those vibhuti packets in the same pocket. He said, no, that is for you and this is for your brother." So what Swami gave second time, I put in the other pocket. Once again, I took namaskar and he blessed and I left Parthi. I went home very happy, went and informed my mother that Swami has given prasadam and now we don't need to worry. As usual, brother was sick. He was on the bed almost for 10 days. I went and gave him vibhuti packets which Swami has given. And I witnessed the first miracle directly in my life. The packets which Swami gave to my brother were full of medicine. The packets which Swami gave me was vibhuti. Needless to say, within a week he was completely cured of his ailment. The vibhuti which Swami gave to my brother was so bitter that nobody wanted to even taste it. You keep anywhere, the whole room used to smell like a medical shop. I do not know when and where the vibhuti got transformed into medicine. This was the first direct miracle which I witnessed, and then onwards I decided the only objective in my life is I should be either a student or as a teacher serving in his institution. I do not know when that is going to happen, but I thought even at the end of my career, for at least for a few years, I should be serving Swami. And this prayer continued and I finished my BSc followed by my MSc. And from childhood, I had a wish that I should be a school teacher. My friends used to say that I am going for engineering, I am going for medicine, I am going for law. I used to say that I want to be a teacher. I want to be a school teacher. Only one wish I had, I should be a teacher in one of the best schools in India. It should be a CBSE school. These were the thoughts running in my mind, but just a wish, nothing more than that. So as soon as I finished BSc, I applied for MSc. I got seat in maths, physics, chemistry, all subjects. But I chose maths. The reason being that the college used to be in the morning session, 8 to 10. Whereas if you take physics or chemistry, the college used to be during daytime, almost for 5 to 6 hours. So I will attend the college in morning. And I became a teacher in school. And I used to work in school from 12 to 5. And rest all time I used to devote in serving Swami in so many different ways. As a Balvikas Guru, as a Sevadal, organizing various programs. And in the meantime, Swami started a new program called Education Human Values. So we have taken up the responsibility of training the primary school teachers in the state in 3 years' time about this Human Values program, which the government of Madhya Pradesh accepted at that point of time. Mr. Arjun Singh was the chief minister, and he happened to be devotee of Bhagwan, so they accepted it. So under that, the teachers who are there in this profession were made resource people, and we were training the people. It was the year 1985, I came to Parthi, and as I mentioned, I wanted to be a teacher in Swami's institution. I was looking for an opportunity. I came to Parthi to attend a national seminar for which all of us who are part of Education Human Values program were eligible. It was organized in Puttaparthi on 1st and 2nd of May 1985. At the end of that conference, Swami was kind enough to bless all of us with Pad Namaskar. There were around 3,000 people from all over the country who came to attend that particular program of 2 days workshop. And as Swami was passing by me, while giving Namaskar, I prayed to Swami, saying, "Swami, I wish to work in your school." Immediately, Swami took interest and asked what I have studied, what I can teach. And then he said, "Go and meet principal. Tell that Swami has asked me to join and give him an application." So I went and met. At that point of time, the great man, Professor Habbu, happened to the principal. He was a principled man as a principal. Wonderful things you can learn from him, from his life, the way he has dedicated his life in molding the character of the students at that point of time was amazing. Very inspiring person. Right from morning 6 o'clock, he will be there in the playground watching various activities on the playground during school hours. After school hours, he will visit the hostel. He was a very great, inspiring person. So I went and met him, and I told that Swami asked me to meet you. And he said, he has asked me to give an application. So I gave the application, and his response was, "Brother, there is no vacancy." I didn't say anything. I came back. And once that Namaskar session was over, we were part of the public. So I was sitting with public. And once you are sitting with public, you do not know when, again, you will get an opportunity to speak to Swami. So I was sitting in public. I don't know what is going to happen. Swami came for giving darshan. I was sitting in fourth or fifth line, I still remember. Swami called me and asked, "What did principal say?" I said, "Swami, he says that there is no vacancy." Swami said, "Don't worry. Wait. I will tell." So even though I came here just for 2 days to attend the seminar, and since Swami has asked me to wait, I stayed back. People left. Almost for a month I stayed. And those were the best days in my life. Almost every day Bhagwan will interact. If he is going in car, he will stop the car and keep talking, keep inquiring. Several interviews he has blessed me with. 1 full month passed. One day when he came out to give darshan, when he was passing, he said, "See, I want to take you, but principal is saying there is no vacancy. What shall I do?" I said, "Swami, whatever you say." He said, "Don't worry. Go back home. You will get a very good job. Come after 1 year. If he does not take you in school, I will take you in university." I was thrilled, took Namaskar, went back to my hometown. And then, very surprisingly, after finishing our MSc and B.Ed, we happened to apply for lecturership in government colleges. And you know, anything you apply in government colleges, you are not sure when and what is going to happen. So I was continuing my teaching in the school where I was working. And you believe it or not, the day I reached home, just the previous day, I got an appointment as lecturer in government college. So I went there, joined the college, started working, but waiting for 1 year to get over. Finally, the year ended, came back to Parthi, hoping that Swami is going to take me in. But now, there was a different story waiting me. Swami stopped looking at me. Swami stopped interacting with me. Swami stopped taking letters from me. And I was puzzled. What happened? What mistake I have committed? Started introspecting. And after a few days, Swami left Parthi, came to Vrindavan. And there were rumors that Swami will come back in a week. So I thought, okay, let me wait in Parthi. I kept waiting. Then I got the information that Swami has gone to Kodai. After some days, I got information that Swami has come back to Vrindavan. I thought it is high time that I should go to Vrindavan and wait there than waiting in Parthi, because I am not sure when he will be back to Parthi. Came to Vrindavan. during those days, for some reason, Swami was giving darshan only twice a week. It was on Thursday and Sunday. So there used to be huge crowd. And you sit in lines, you will be blessed with 30th line or 20th line, you do not know. There used to be a beautiful Sai Ram shed. We all used to gather there. Swami used to come and give darshan and attend bhajans. And every Thursday and Sundays, there used to be akhand bhajan. I remember it was a Sunday. Swami came out. I was sitting very far. There was no way I could approach Swami. Swami came, gave darshan, sat for some bhajans and left. And the bhajans continued. As Swami left, I saw that people were moving out. So I started going closer and closer. By the time it was evening, I was sitting in the first line. And I thought that evening when Swami comes out, I will catch him. But he was not coming out. And there were rumors saying that sometimes Swami does not come. He sends words to give arati. I was cursing myself, scolding him, that with so much of difficulty I got the chance to sit in first line and he is not turning up. Almost it was 5:15, suddenly he decided to come and bless us. He came. As he came close to me, I knelt down and prayed to him, Swami, I wish to work in your school. He heard very patiently and asked, which school? I said, Swami, high school. Oh, Ishwaramba school, he asked. I said, Swami, English medium school. He said, that is not high school, that is higher secondary school. I thought, yes, Swami. He said, okay, you do one thing, you go back to Parthi and tell principal that I will come tomorrow and decide. So I took namaskar, left for Parthi, and as per his word, next day afternoon he came back to Parthi. As soon as he got down from the car, he called Habbu sir, and I was taken in school next day. Then onwards, it was a most wonderful time. First few years, I happened to stay in ashram. So we had a privilege of having darshan morning and evening. I was very reluctant, in spite of Swami sending word two times that I should join hostel. The reason being, morning darshans used to be very unique. Students were not permitted to come, and few teachers were allowed to sit in the portico. And every day, invariably, after interviews, he will come out and interact with us. So nobody wanted to miss that. But Habbu sir kept on insisting that I should join hostel. Then he said, okay, if you are not joining hostel, visit the hostel in the evening and help the students during study hours. I started going to hostel. And I saw that there are just three teachers managing more than 300 students. I thought it will be selfish in my part, staying in Mandir and not joining the hostel. So I started praying to Swami, saying that, Swami, I am very sorry. I was not aware of the facts. Now if you tell, I will join the hostel. So this prayer continued. And then next year, once again, Swami sent word. I sat in front and prayed to Swami, and he blessed me with an interview and said, join the hostel. Serve my students. I was very happy and joined the hostel. The moment we join hostel, that morning privileges are gone. We'll be going for darshan only in the evening, and that too, so many people. But it right from that time till date, I'm staying in the hostel. It's such a beautiful experience, living with students and spending time with them. Somehow I feel I have found fulfillment in my life, serving Swami's children. There was many occasions when he has confirmed it. I remember still 1995, the new hostel was constructed, and I knew that the moment hostel comes, there will be requirement of general stores and things which boys like to buy. So much before we moved to the hostel, I planned and prepared And I was aware that Swami will visit the hostel at least twice before boys could get in. That was the year of Swami's 65th birthday. There were lots of devotees coming. The inauguration of the hostel was done on 23rd July 1995. But Swami said that you can move in after the birthday. First, my devotees will stay here, and then after they leave, you can join the hostel. So we made preparations. We arranged things, thinking that even if the devotees are going to stay here, they may be requiring various things. So we arranged those things. And one day Swami came to hostel, inaugurated the general stores, and blessed all of us. Just the day when I, along with few students, sat in front, inviting Swami to come and inaugurate the general stores, he came here, came to me and said, "What's the matter?" I said, "Swami, please come and bless the general stores and fruit stall." He said, "If you work in stores, who will take care of the boys?" I said, "Swami, that is the first priority, but this also we will like to have." Swami said, "Manchidi." Then he came to hostel, inaugurated the stores, fruit stall, blessed all of us. After that, whenever he happened to come to hostel, he made it a point to visit these two places invariably and bless the students, those who are serving there. So in this particular manner, he kept guiding. Many wonderful things happened as soon as I joined the Swami's school. After 1 year of my stay in the school, one day principal, Professor Habbu, called me and said, "See, you have submitted all your mark sheets, but you have not submitted your degree certificates." So I went to my hometown, Bilaspur, where I studied, and I informed my parents that I have to go to Raipur. Raipur happened to be the capital of Chhattisgarh right now. So the distance between Bilaspur and Raipur is around 120 kilometers. And there is a very convenient train called Howrah-Bombay Mail, which arrives in Bilaspur around 7:30, reaches Raipur around 9:30. You reach Raipur and then go to university, finish your work. And in the evening train time, the return train, that is Bombay-Howrah Mail, will be arriving Raipur around 5 o'clock. And you will be back to Bilaspur by 7 o'clock. So I have planned that way. And I mentioned to it to my father. My father said, "You cannot travel by that train." I said, "Why?" The reason was, many boys from Bilaspur used to go to Raipur for university work. And college students used to consider that it is their privilege that they should travel in train without ticket. The train used to come from Howrah, and generally the Bengalis have the habit of sleeping late night and getting up late. So the train will reach in the morning around 7:30. These students will get into the compartments, wake up the passengers, force them to sit, and they will occupy the berths. They created such a nonsense that there were several complaints, and finally the railway authorities took a decision and made a rule that people cannot travel by the train if the journey is that of less than 500 kilometers. So things were going on this way, and this my father informed. But immediately he said, "Don't worry. You go by passenger train which starts at 6:30. That also reaches Raipur by 9:30. I said, "Fine." I called up from my home, and I was informed that the passenger train is in right time. I came to station, purchased the ticket, and I was waiting for train to arrive. Suddenly there was an announcement saying that the passenger train is late by 1 hour. I thought, okay, instead of reaching there by 9:30, I will reach there by 10:30, but still I can complete my work in the university. I was waiting, almost 45 minutes passed. Suddenly there was an announcement saying that the passenger train is indefinite late. So I do not know what I have to do. Just then the Howrah-Bombay Mail arrived. So I thought, anyway, I have purchased ticket. And if the TT asks me, I will ask him to calculate the balance of the fare and I will pay it. Thinking that, I got into the Howrah Bombay mail. No TT came. I was very comfortable. Got down in railway station, Raipur. And I was moving out along with other passengers. And you know, near the gate, a TT will be checking your tickets. For us, every ticket appears to be same. But being ticket collector and to check the ticket being their profession, they can easily make out which is a passenger ticket, which is an express train ticket. So the moment I gave the ticket, he caught me and said, how could you travel by a passenger ticket in an express train? I was trying to explain. There was a lot of crowd. He said, stand in the side. I was standing there. He allowed everybody to go. And then he started scolding left and right. You educated people, you do these things. I was trying to explain. He's not ready to listen. Took me to the chief ticket collector's office. He made me sit there. He, along with other people, they all started scolding. I don't know what to do. I was trying to tell them that the situation was this. They were not ready to listen. When I saw that they are simply shouting, I also shout back saying that you are the people who are responsible to run the trains late and you blame us. I said, you don't want to listen to me. And I explained. I said, you tell me now what you could have done in that situation. He said, we would have traveled next day. I said, very coolly you are telling it. But if the situation demands, you will also be doing the same thing. He said, you cannot go from here till you pay the 500 kilometer fare with penalty. I was not having so much of money. So I was sitting there wondering what to do. To be very frank, I didn't remember Swami. I didn't pray to Swami. I was just sitting there. Hardly 3 or 4 minutes passed. There enters in the office a gentleman with white dress, looks at me and says, Sairam. I was stunned. In this far off place, almost 2,000 kilometers from Puttaparthi, who is this person? I had never seen him. Looks at me and says, Sairam. And signals me, get up. So I got up. He said, follow me. I followed him. He coolly took me out of the office and I went outside. And I started profusely thanking him. I said, thank you very much, sir. I was in a problem. I am so grateful to you. And all that I started telling, he said, don't thank me. Thank Baba. I said, yes, sir. I am thankful to Baba. But I am very grateful to you that you have come to my rescue. He said, no, I didn't do anything. It's all Baba's doing. Then he started explaining. I was wondering how this person could simply take me out. What is he? All that. Then he gave the beautiful explanation. He said, till very recently, I was the chief TT of this railway station. So that was my office. And as a habit, even after retirement, whenever I find time, I visit the station and I go to that office. Since I was retired, I being Swami's devotee, I was an active member in the organization and I practice meditation. So today morning, when I was sitting and meditating, I heard Swami telling me, go to station. I thought, what is this? Swami is asking me to go to station. I ignored it few times, but Swami was so persistent that I should go to station. So I was wondering why I should go to station. All of my life I have gone to station only. But since it was Swami's command, I came here. Once I came to the station, I don't know where to go. So as usual, I came to the office. And as I entered the office, I saw you. And I understood that this is what Swami wanted me to do. So this is all Swami's doing. And it was Swami who has saved you in this situation. With God, there are only delays, no denials. As we come to Swami's fold, not only we are blessed with good health and peace of mind, but all our family people are taken care of. to such an extent that each one has his own experience in the family receiving Swami's grace. I, being the eldest son, my parents had a wish that my thread ceremony should be performed as early as possible, because without my thread ceremony being done, other brothers cannot go through various programs like thread ceremony or marriage or anything. So they kept on pressurizing me that I should agree for that. But somehow I decided that if my thread ceremony is to be done, Swami should perform it. That was my prayer. And I took enough chances to tell Swami about it. But whenever I will approach Swami and tell or pray for thread ceremony, he will immediately say, "Why thread ceremony? I will perform your marriage." He will crack some joke, people all around will laugh, and I will sit down. This happened 3 to 4 times. Then I thought, I will not ask anymore. Let him do whenever he wants. But the pressure from home was so much. Every year when I go for holidays, they will ask, "When is he performing? Can't you get this much done?" They will think it is very easy with Swami, that anything which you want, you can get it done. So I don't answer anything. Once they got so irritated, they said, "We have already fixed your muhurta. Come this day, we will perform here. We cannot wait anymore." I said, "I am sorry. You can have other brothers' thread ceremony done. I am not going to come. If I will have thread ceremony, Swami alone should perform." I was very adamant. And I said, "I am not even going to ask him anymore." Just the next year, during those years, after the Shivaratri celebration, Swami is to come to Vrindavan. So we knew that on particular day, Swami was leaving Parthi. All the hostel teachers we got together, we went to Swami's residence with a prayer, saying that, "Swami, kindly bless all the students with Pad Namaskar. Because once you go now, you generally don't come back before the end of the academic session. And there are good number of students who continue their studies somewhere else, or they go for various jobs. They will not be getting this wonderful opportunity of Pad Namaskar." So with that prayer, we sent our letters inside, and you can never predict how Swami will react in any situation. We thought we will pray, but suddenly we were all called inside. So we went inside. He asked, "Em samacharam?" So we told Swami, "Please bless the." He said, "See, I'm so busy. Nobody to help me. I have to arrange the suitcase. I have to do everything. I'm fully busy. There's no time." We kept pleading Swami, and finally he agreed. He said, "Okay, let them come at 3 o'clock to Purnachandra. I will bless them." So we were happy. Before leaving, during those years, the practice used to be that we can take Swami's namaskar. So we were doing namaskar. When came my turn, he looked at me and said, "When is your thread ceremony?" I said, "Swami, whenever you perform." He said, "Is it? Okay. Now I am going to Vrindavan. From there, I will go to Kodai. Once I come back from Kodai, you get your family, miss, your parents and brothers and everyone. I will perform your thread ceremony in Vrindavan." I was very happy, took namaskar, and Swami left for Vrindavan. During that particular year, during holidays, when I went home, I informed my parents, brothers and everybody, that Swami has agreed to perform thread ceremony. They were not ready to believe. They were telling, "You tell like this only, we don't know what will happen." I said, "If you believe me, please come. Otherwise, I will have it directly from Swami." So we found out Swami's return from Kodai, and we all came together. We were sitting here only. I was sitting here. In the first darshan itself, as he came, he asked thread ceremony. I said, "Swami, whenever you perform." Then he said, "Which is the good day?" I said, "Swami, I don't know." He said, "I will see and tell you." So during the evening darshan time, it was not very regular during that time that evenings he will move around. But that particular day it happened that he came and he asked, "See, coming Sunday is very auspicious, so I will perform." I said, "Nice." I took namaskar. And we had a great good fortune of going inside Trai after the bhajans in the evening. So as we went inside, he called me inside the interview room and made inquiry who are all coming and what arrangements are to be made. Which he performs. So,
Swami made inquiry and whatever I was aware, I have informed him. Suddenly a thought came to me. As my brothers are with me, how about asking for them? So I prayed to Swami.
Please perform thread ceremony for brothers also. He said, why not? Get them also. I will perform for all brothers. So the next day, on the Sunday, we happened to go inside and he created sacred thread for all three of us, called each of us and blessed with Gayatri Mantra, gave a long interview, discussed various things of the family and blessed us. What I learned by this experience is two very important things. One, once you decide that God should do something, you have to wait. Second, when he blesses you profusely. I was just waiting that my thread ceremony Swami should perform, but he blessed all the three brothers with the thread ceremony and everyone was happy. Many, many experiences Swami has given me during these years. One wonderful experience which happened in Vrindavan, I would like to share. During those years, during summer holidays, I used to go home. After going home, many students who were earlier Balvika students, they used to come and they were so eager to know about Swami, Swami's glory. And every evening, we used to have satsang. Even though they were doing professional courses, but somehow they used to find time and come and participate in satsang. So I used to share my experiences and I made it a mandatory that whom
session should spend at least 2 hours time in doing personal sadhana. The sadhana can be of any kind.
They can do namasmarana, they can do japa. If they cannot do anything, at least they should do swadhyaya. They should read Swami's literature. This was the condition and they were all very eager, so they used to do that. To attend that particular satsang, there were two sisters by name Rama and Indu. Both were very devoted, good singers, good speakers, very cultured and highly intelligent girls. Both of them were doing BA and they were also attending. They were so devoted to Swami that on their own they decided that they will dedicate their life in serving Swami. So they had their own plans. They informed the parents that please don't look for our marriage. We will like to serve Swami. But as usual, it happens that parents are worried about the marriage of the daughters. So they know that if they take the proposal, the girls will not agree. So without the knowledge of one of the girls, the marriage was fixed for Rama. But how long you can hide the fact from the girl who is going to get married? The cards were printed and she came to know. And she was very disturbed. She kept on telling parents that, see, I said I will not get married and you are forcing me. I will not get married. So she tried to convince them. They were not convinced. Her father was working in railways. He was an officer. They had a very big bungalow. She had her own room. So she simply entered that room, bolted it from inside, telling parents that if you don't agree for my proposal, I am not going to open it. She kept praying inside. Parents were devotees. They were praying outside. They cannot reveal the secret to anybody because we do not know what message will reach to the boy's side people. So both were praying. You believe it or not, for 2 full days, she did not eat, she did not drink, and kept praying inside. Similarly, parents, particularly his mother, was praying that Swami, please find some solution. On the second day night, Swami appears in her dream. And Swami says, What happened? She said, Swami, they have decided to get me married. I don't want. Swami asked, who fixed the marriage? She said, Swami, parents. Swami said, no. I only fixed the marriage. She said, Swami, I don't want to get married. Swami said, why? She said, Swami, I want to progress spiritually. Swami asked, what does that mean? She had no answer. Then Swami said, what is that you want by progressing spiritually? She said, Swami, I don't know anything, but they say that we get mukti. Swami said, oh, you want mukti? I promise you that in this birth itself we will get mukti. Now get agreed for the marriage. So in that particular manner, she agreed. Even though it was a dream, it was so very clear. Morning when she got up, she remembered the whole thing. She opened the room, parents were very happy. And when I was coming back, she gave me the card saying that, Bhaiya, give it to Swami. This is the first card. I said, fine. That was the year 1992, I believe. We came for summer course. Professor Sampath happens to be the vice chancellor at that point of time. We were given various duties to do during that particular time. And Swami was so happy with the boys that almost every day he used to come for food sessions, lunch as well as dinner. One particular evening, Swami did not come for dinner. And there were rumors, or I should say, there was information that Mr. S.B. Chavan, who happened to the Home Minister at that point of time, had come for Swami's darshan and Swami had dinner with him. So he has not come to have dinner with boys. So we were all convinced. We finished our duties. I went and slept off. And that night Swami appears in my dream and says, I have done a wonderful thing for you. I said, nice Swami, but what is it? He said, guess. I was not able to make any guess. He kept asking. I kept looking at him and then finally said, see, I went and attended your sister's marriage. To be very frank, I did not remember that it was her marriage. We are three brothers. We call everybody sisters, but don't get attached to anybody in any way. So I did not remember. Swami said, you don't believe? See, smell my hand. I had dinner also. So I smelled and yes, Swami. But I was not able to make out. And the dream ended. Got up in the morning. I was thinking, whose marriage? Then suddenly it struck to me. Is it her marriage? Even though she has told, but I did not remember for the reason that once we come here, we are so busy with our own schedule that we don't remember anything of home. So I called up and came to know that it was her marriage. Literally, the food which was offered to Swami has disappeared from the plate and Swami blessed her profusely. Let me end up my talk with another wonderful thing happened very recently. It was month of February and it has been our tradition that just before the board examinations, students offer their gratitude and we call it a gratitude program, during which they share their experiences, they sing beautiful songs expressing their gratefulness to Swami for all that Swami has done. So this year it happened on 20th of February. So the program got over. And it has been tradition that at the end of the program, the principal of the school, he will take all the admit cards. You know, all the admit cards will be almost in the size of A4. Almost of 200 students, 10th and 12th boys and girls, all the admit cards he will take it to Swami. When Swami was physically there, I remember one occasion, personally Swami distributed those admit cards to students. Another occasion he blessed it and asked to distribute. So that used to be the practice. So even now, at the end of the program, principal takes those admit cards and places at Swami's feet, seeking Swami's blessings. So he did that, and he decided that he will bring it to school on the next day morning. So we were all waiting. Somehow he forgot. It was a big file, very thick file of more than 200 students' admit cards. He did not get. Afternoon, he gets a call from home saying that you have kept something at Swami's feet and there is vibhuti on that. So immediately rushed home to find out, and he saw there is vibhuti. Suddenly he thought, why not I leave it? Let us see what happens. Today is only 21st of February. Exams are going to be from 1st of March. So let us wait and see. And he says, day after day, the amount of vibhuti started growing. It was 27th of February. He called some of us to take those admit cards. And he said, we will take it as it is, because seeing which children will be very inspired. In fact, this year we were so stressed with too many activities. You can imagine, Parthi, even tomorrow morning exam, we will be going to Mandir on the previous day, attending the program, whatever is happening. Sometimes it will end at 6 o'clock, someday it is at 7 o'clock. But it has been the thing. So we are continuing that particular tradition. Exam, no exam, we will be going to Mandir every day. So boys were stressed, and I am sure many of them would have prayed to Swami. And who else but their mother knows their agony? And Swami wanted to give them confidence, and he gave confidence in that particular manner. We got the whole thing, the whole mat with the things, and placed it on the table for everybody to see. And then principal asked some of us, he got small vibhuti plastic bags. He told us to put vibhuti in that. As we started putting, surprisingly we found that there were small rudrakshas in that. So immediately we informed him, and we thought for a while, and he said, you do one thing, put one rudraksha in each packet. We don't know how many are there. So we started putting. You believe it or not, there were enough for everyone. All of them, they got those small rudrakshas with vibhuti. They were very happy, very confident. They wrote exams well. And as all of you are aware, we got very good results this year. We were not discussing about the results with anyone for one reason. The reason was, the top six ranks were girls. So we were feeling shy to tell. Even though result was very good, we were not talking about it. Once in a year we have a faculty meeting between boys wing teachers and girls wing teachers to discuss about syllabus, examinations and all that. So the teachers happened to come to our school. In our department we were discussing. I congratulated the teacher, saying that girl students have done so well. I started asking, what is the secret? One teacher said, no secret, we never expected, it's all Swami's grace. The other teacher said, this batch was very unique, she said. I said, what way? She says, we don't remember a single occasion when we have to tell the students to sit for studies. Somewhere during Guru Purnima, they all got together and they decided that they will do something to get a good name for Swami. And that was their motivating factor, which they kept reminding themselves time and again, and they kept studying so much. There were occasions when we had to say, you studied enough, now you stop and do something else. She said, maybe that is the reason. I said, nice. Exactly after 10 days of that, just the one day before Guru Purnima, we came to know that our school stands 8th in the country out of 5,500 CBSE schools. So I was very happy. But suddenly something was disturbing me. I was thinking, and she said, see, toward the end they had only one thing. They kept praying, Swami, please write through us, please write through us. And she said, maybe Swami wrote through them. So I started wondering, if Swami has written their examination, then school should come first, isn't it? If Swami does something, he cannot be 6th and 4th and 8th and 9th. I started thinking about it. Suddenly an idea came. Even though it is one school, But boys wing and girls wing are fully different. We never meet each other. We never get together. So that school runs independently. This school runs independently, there by ladies teachers, here by gents teacher. So it stuck to me that, see, that was the prayer of girls. Why not calculate their average? We were 8th in the country because our school average was 90.02. The school which was standing first in the country was having the average 91.02. We were exactly 1% less. So I took their marks and calculated their average. Can you believe that their average was 94.3? When God works through you, you will be first only. Some beautiful lessons to be learned. Just think, young students, 12th standard girls, coming together, deciding to do something to get a good name for Swami. We all want to do things to make Swami happy. We take many resolutions, but most of the time we fail. It's not one individual. All students got together. Keep inspiring each other. Keep recollecting the resolution which they took and started working. And finally, God, when He works through you, you are always first. With these words, wholeheartedly, I thank Bhagwan for giving me this wonderful opportunity of sharing the beautiful experiences which has given me in this wonderful place called Vrindavan. The moment I step in, so many memories flash. The wonderful time. If I sit here, I remember what happened to me here. If I sit in that corner, I remember what happened to me in that corner. If I go to hostel, I remember what happened to me in the hostel. I step inside Trai, I remember the wonderful times. He has blessed me with so many beautiful experiences. I am very sure, not only me, each one is blessed by Him in a very, very unique way. Each one who have come to His fold are blessed. Praying Bhagwan to bless the organizers who are conducting this wonderful program and giving opportunity to all of us to come and share our experiences with all of you. Thanking Bhagwan, I consider it a great chance given to me to express my gratefulness to Him for all that which He has done all these years and the years to come. Thank you, Sai Ram.